24. I didn't just randomly pick the number. To some of you, it may be a reminder of a certain date. Some of you might relate it age-wise. But to me, 24 is the number that represents the biggest victory of my life so far. 2 months ago, my team and I ranked on the top 24 out of 35 teams in one of the biggest world championships in the world. And I'll tell you all about it. When I was 3, I was lucky enough to realize what my passion is, which is gymnastics. And unlike most of my teammates, my parents didn't force me into going to training every day. And even though I pretty much had no clue what gymnastics is, I really liked it. 2 years later, I won my very first gold medal. And from that moment on, I was determined to get as many as medals as one could ever earn. So you know how life gets harder as you grow older and stuff? Well, tough isn't even close to describing what it's like for a developing gymnast. As I got older, competition started getting harder. People whom I've never heard of started appearing out of nowhere, trying to beat me and trying to take my place. Challengers tried to fight me, they tried to beat me, and they tried to bring me down. But that was no way for me to back out, and I never did. Because let me tell you one thing, your goals become even more valuable to you when someone else is trying to take them away from you. So one of the worst phases of my life was when I was 14. We were maturing in the world of gymnastics, and competition was just terror. Little did I know was that everything I was wishing for and everything I was working so hard for could all be lost in just a blink of an eye. Out of nowhere, I started feeling this very unusual pain in my leg. And because I ignored it, it was my way of pretending that it just wasn't there. But after a lot of endurance and a lot of suffering, I had to tell my coach. And from then on, all the complications just kept piling up. Little did I know was that recovery was the hardest part of all. At that time, I was basically lost. I had no idea where I stood, and at times it just seemed impossible for me to get back up there. And hope slowly faded away, I lost all my sources of motivation, and everything just seemed impossible for me. Until one day, with the help of my 6 extraordinary teammates, we managed to get back up there. My injury was so serious, yet no doctor could accurately diagnose it. Their solution was so simple though, quit. But that was no option for me. A while later, my teammates and I, which are over there by the way, decided that we would go after the one thing we've been waiting for our entire lives. The one thing every athlete wishes to achieve, and the one thing that we know would bring us complete and utter satisfaction, the Olympics. So being rational, we thought that the best way to start off was to set up a meeting with our federation. But who are we, 6 girls, standing in the faces of one hell of a federation? And despite our various schedules, and the fact that 5 out of 6 girls had serious injuries that they couldn't endure every day, we were ready to start our fight away. All that was left for us was complete support from the board members. And we did get it, just not as soon as you think you did. So a while later, we started practicing. And by time, we were good enough to win first place in the All African Championships. By then, we've earned their trust, and attention started creeping in. So our next step was to focus on what mattered the most, which was the World Championships, which, by the way, was our final shot at reserving a place for the Olympics. And having only 6 months left to train, which I know 6 months may seem like a lot of time, but compared to the other teams who've been training years and years for this kind of intensity and tension and stress, we were so far behind, and we had a lot of catching up to do. So we decided that we'd dedicate our 3 months of summer for training and training only. So I want you to imagine 8 hours of consecutive training every day for 3 straight months. Our social lives were literally hanging by a thread, and our lives literally sucked. But we knew it would all be worth it at the very end. On the day of competition, as ready as we thought we were all dying from fear inside. By the time we were done, we were pretty hopeless. I mean, everyone was saying that we should be optimistic, but we were being more realistic, knowing that we would never rank from the top 24 countries. And while we just waited there, trying to accept the fact that it was all over, a guy came up to us and was like, "You guys know you still rank 21, right?" And that was when all the anxiety kept rushing back in, and that one tiny piece of hope that we thought we lost came back. And while we waited there for the scores to come out, and they did, all the happiness in the world was filled inside us. And with 0.1 difference in scores, my team and I ranked the top 24 out of 35 countries who qualified for the Olympic Games of 2020. The point is, people are gonna push you down. They're gonna misread you, and they're gonna tell you no a million times. My team and I overcame injuries, doctors, and a lot of discouragement. But we kept going anyway, because we knew we'd get there one day. A friend of mine once told me, success is where opportunity meets hard work. So you know what? Grab every opportunity you get and never let go. Thank you.